Sacred Heart High School welcomes you. Children, today we will be studying mathematics for standard 7th, chapter number 10, banks and simple interest. Children, we have often heard the word bank from our parents, but what is the bank and how does it function? Let us say it today. A bank is a government recognized institution that carries out transactions of money. Banks make it easier for us to plan the use of money, that is, it helps us to do the financial planning. We can either deposit cash money in a bank or withdraw cash from it. To deposit is to put the money in the bank and to withdraw is to take the money out of the bank. Now let us see different types of account in the bank. The first type of account is a current account. Children, what is a current account? A current account is mainly for traders and those dealing in money on the daily basis. An account holder can deposit or withdraw money any number of times in a day. The bank issues a passbook for this account and also a checkbook for the current account. Now let us see the next kind of account, which is the savings account. Children, a savings account is one where a person can deposit the minimum amount and open a savings account. In some of the banks, not even the minimum amount is required to open the savings account. The bank pays some interest on the basis of the daily credit balance in the account. Now let us see the third type of account, which is the recurring deposit account. What is the recurring deposit account? This is the account where the account holder can decide the amount to be deposited every month in the account. The bank gives us an interest on the deposit, which is more than that paid for the savings account. So such kind of account is known as the recurring deposit account. The fourth kind of account is a fixed deposit. A depositor deposits a certain amount for a fixed period of time in the bank. This deposit attracts a greater rate of interest than the savings account. So, here in the fixed account, the rates are different in different banks. Senior citizens get a slightly greater rate of interest than the usual only in the fixed deposit account. Now we have learnt about different kinds of account. Now let us see what does the word interest and rate of interest means, which we have heard previously. Let us suppose one of my friend wants an amount of 10 rupees from me and she tells me that she will give it back to me after a period of 1 year. I tell her, yes, surely you can take the money, that is 10 rupees, from me, but after that period of time, a period of 1 year, you will have to return an extra 2 rupees to me, that is 10 plus 2 is equal to 12. Why will she return 2 rupees extra to me? Because I allowed her to keep my 10 rupees for a period of 1 year. So this amount, principal amount, which she had borrowed from me, it is known as the principal. The 2 rupees that she will pay extra after a period of 1 year is known as the interest. So now you know, children, what is the interest. The principal amount is the money she borrowed from me. Interest is the extra money she will pay to me after a period of 1 year. So when we are told to count the amount to be paid to the bank after a certain period of time, this is the formula to be applied. Principal, that is the money you borrow from the bank, plus interest, that is the interest, extra money that you will pay to the bank after a period of 1 year, is equal to the amount, that is total amount that you will pay to the bank after a period of 1 year. 1 year is the time period, or your N, that is number of years. Now let us see example related to it. Neha took a loan of 5,000 rupees or 50,000 rupees at 12 BCPA to buy a two-wheeler. What amount will she return to the bank at the end of 1 year? So Neha has taken a loan of 50,000 rupees at 12% per annum to buy a two-wheeler. What amount will she return to the bank at the end of the year? We are supposed to find out the amount that Neha has to return after a period of 1 year with interest. So let us find it out. The amount, that is the total money owed to the bank at the end of the time, is to be calculated here. The principal is 50,000 rupees and at the rate of 12% per annum. We shall write the ratio of interest to the capital in two ways to obtain an equation. We have already studied, children, in the chapter equation in standard 6, how to write the equation. So let us write on 50,000 rupees, let the interest be x rupees. We don't know the interest, so we have considered it as x. On 100 rupees, the interest is 12 rupees. So now we'll write the equation, that is x by 50,000 is equal to 12 by 100. Now, to solve this equation, we know that first we need to balance it. So whatever is done on the left hand side should also be done on the right hand side. So we multiply both the sides by 50,000. After multiplying, the answer we are left with is x is equal to 6,000. The value of x is 6,000. 6,000 is the interest Neha has to pay to the bank. Therefore, we know the formula amount to be returned to the bank is principal, the original amount plus interest. That is the extra money. So the principal amount was 50,000 plus 6,000. Therefore, amount to be returned to the bank is rupees 56,000. After a period of a year, Neha will return 56,000 with interest to the bank at the end of the year. This is how we find out the amount. Now children, let us see what is simple interest. When at the time of returning the loan to the bank, we have to pay back an amount somewhat bigger than the borrowed loan amount, this additional amount is called as simple interest. Factors of simple interest are principal amount, rate of interest, and time period in years. Principal amount, you know, is the original amount you take from the bank. Rate of interest is the extra money, and time period for how much years. The number of years is known as time period. The formula for counting the simple interest is P, that is principal amount in rupees, into R, that is rate of interest percent per annum, into N. N is your number of years upon 100. This is the formula for counting the simple interest. Suppose children, we have to buy this tractor. So you want to buy this tractor, it costs rupees 50,000. You decide to get a 5-year loan with a 6.5% interest rate of rupees 15,000. How much interest will you pay? So children, here we have to find out how much interest will you have to pay to the bank after a period of 5 years. That is, we will first write the given information, then we know the formula for simple interest, which is P into N into R upon 100. We have the values of principal, which is 15,000. N is number of years, which is 5 years. And we also know the rate of interest, which is 6.5. We have to find out the simple interest. So after calculation, the answer we are left with is 4,875. Therefore, to buy this tractor, we will pay an interest of rupees 4,875. This is the how we solve the sums of simple interest. Children, I hope the concept of banks and simple interest is clear to you all.